Hi, and welcome to this session about Dailymotion's continuous delivery story. So, a bit about me first. My name is Vincent. I'm working at Dailymotion. You can find me on GitHub or Twitter. And if you have other questions after the talk, you can still find me on the Kubernetes Slack channel. So a bit of context about Dailymotion. We are a video hosting company focusing on premium content. And we also have our own ad tech platform, which was started 3 years ago. And I'm going to focus more on the ad tech platform in this talk. On the tech side, we have a lot of hundreds of repositories, applications, services, and a lot of different languages. Most of them hosted in production on Kubernetes and geo-distributed in multiple regions worldwide. So let's start this talk with issue. issue we had with our ad tech platform 2 years ago, and a bit more, when it was first started. Our initial issue was mainly the time to market. So it was way too long. We did one release every 2 weeks at the beginning because we had sprints of 2 weeks. So at the end of each sprint, one release. So we have around 10 or 15 components in this product. And we release everything together. That's what we call the Big Bang release at that time. And it's also impacting the testing phase, which was way too slow because we used to run all the validation tests in staging in our staging environment. So after the release for all the components at once. So we had it was slow. We had lots of issues managing the staging environment, like configuration, data, and so on. And we did way too many manual operations for the release and for the deployment, because that's something we didn't do often enough. It was manual and error prone and so on. So what can we do about that? Release early, release often, of course. That's a classic one. If we release a small batch of work and incremental change, so more often, there is less risk and we can release regularly. So independent release and deployment. So we don't want to release all our components, our services at once. We want to release them individually. So it will be easier to work at different speed. We want to move responsibilities to the developers. You know the classic, you build it, you run it. We extended it with you build it, you test it, you run it. So shift left a lot of things so that the developer can do more. Test early. So before we used to test after the release. So it was a lot of going back and forth and so on. And what we want to do is to test before the release. So ensure that each release has been tested as it should and that it's ready to go to production. And of course, automate all the things because manual operation are error prone and we want to avoid errors as much as possible. So how can we do that? So our first decision was to move to Kubernetes, mainly because most of the other products and applications at Dailymotion were already hosted on Kubernetes, but also because it's a declarative configuration. So it's much easier to define all our configuration and store it in the Git repository, for example, and audit it, update it, and so on. We also want to move from our old classic CI setup, which was based on Jenkins, to a real continuous delivery platform. And we went with Jenkins X. So why Jenkins X? In 2018, like 2 years ago, when it was just announced, the first reason, of course, is because it's built on top of Kubernetes, and we want to move to Kubernetes. At the beginning, Jenkins X was built with Jenkins inside of it to run all the pipeline. That for us, that was a good, so it's not the case anymore. But for us at that time, it was just something good because we were already used to Jenkins. We already had a lot of Jenkins file with a declarative pipeline. Developers were used to the DSL, to the UI. So it was good to have something we knew inside a whole new world of Kubernetes and different projects and so on. Jenkins X use Helm to package and deploy application. That's something good for us too, because Helm is already used at Dailymotion for a lot of different application. And there is one killer feature in Jenkins X, so preview environments. So I'm going to talk more about it later. But in a few words, the preview environments lets you build and deploy each pull request in isolation from the other one. That's very good because we can use it to have a preview of our application before it will be released. But also we can run integration tests before the release. And Jenkins X support runs on the Google Cloud and GitHub. That's what we're using, so good for us. So we came to Jenkins X mainly for the tools, but we stay for the practice. So I'm going to talk more about the practice because that's something very important in continuous delivery and Jenkins X in particular. Jenkins X is an opinionated set of practice. These practices are described in the Accelerate book or in the Dora DevOps reports. And I'm going to cite Victor Fartik, who has a very good definition, I think, of what is Jenkins X. It's a codified good practice for the full lifecycle of the application. So there are two very important things here. The first one is the codified good practice. So the good practice, Jenkins X is the implementation of a set of good practices that are known to work well together. So you don't have to fight on which practice to use and will it work well with another one and so on. When you use Jenkins X, you know that other practices codified inside of it are known to work well together. The second important point is the full lifecycle of the application. It doesn't stop at just building your application or creating a release or a tag or something like that. And we'll see that later, but it can bring much more. So that's, I think the full lifecycle is very important. So if we deep dive into the practice a bit more, Jenkins X use a trunk-based development as a core practice. That means you're going to write short-lived branch. So you write your new feature or your bug fix and you merge it to master as soon as possible. And when you will merge that pull request, Jenkins X will automatically create a new release that will be ready to go to production. So one important thing about the pipeline in Jenkins X is that you have two sets of pipelines. You have the pull request pipelines and the release pipelines. It's very important because that's an example of why Jenkins X is opinionated, how it is opinionated. In most tools, you'll just have a generic pipeline and it's your role to add a condition to know when you want to execute specific steps or not. Yeah, it's already well-defined for you. The pull request pipeline is going to be used to build your pull request, meaning it will, for example, deploy the preview environment, run the integration test on top of it, of course, run the unit test and whatever. And the release pipeline will have a completely different job. It will create a new release. It will promote it using GitOps to different repositories and so on. So speaking about GitOps, it's a core practice of Jenkins X, meaning all the configuration for the different environments, whether it's a preview environment or the staging environment, production environment, or whatever else environment you want to define, it will be defined in Git. So each environment is a Git repository with all the definition inside that Git repository, like the version of the application installed, the specific configuration per application per environment, and so on. And each update to an environment is done using a pull request in GitHub. That means we can validate the change with a pull request pipeline, and we can apply them with the pipeline too. So that's about the core practice. So what are the benefits? It just works. So when you install it and you import your application, you don't have to reinvent the wheel. You don't have to spend a lot of time rewriting your pipeline because just going to do the right thing and to create your pull request, your release for you, and so on. And also very important, it avoids all the debates you can have in your team about what is the best practice that we want to use and so on, where everybody has a strong opinion. When the tool comes with a good set of practice, if you agree with them, just follow them, and it will be easier instead of debating around that. Of course, you might say that you don't agree with all the practice that comes with Jenkins X. In that case, don't use it and use another tool. A big benefit of Jenkins X is that it's continuously evolving. So it's not something you're going to install once and forget about it. No, because regularly new practices are coming in and new tools too. For example, ChatOps, which is the way you can interact with your CI/CD platform through chat. For example, through the comments in a GitHub pull request. You can say you want to rerun the pipeline, you want to, and so on. Or progressive delivery. Progressive delivery is a way the platform will ensure that your deployment will be a success, or otherwise it will just fall back. So it will monitor a set of metrics and progressively deploy send more traffic to your new application. And if something goes wrong, it will just fall back automatically. So you don't have to do it yourself. And that's an example of where Jenkins X is managing the full lifecycle of your application and not just only creating a release and leaving you to do everything else yourself. It's also integrating with new tools regularly. For example, it started with Jenkins to run all the pipeline internally. But now it's using Tecton, which is another open source project from the Continuous Delivery Foundation. An awesome tool, by the way. Lighthouse, which is a rewrite of a fork of Pro from the Kubernetes project, Flagger to manage your progressive delivery, and so on. So that means that if you want to embrace Jenkins X, you shouldn't just install it once and leave it there and forget about it. The project is continuously evolving, so if you want to really benefit from it, you should upgrade it regularly and invest some time in it, because it's so much easier if you just continuously take care of it. The same way, it's easier to manage your own application if you continuously deploy it than if you deploy it to production every month or every 6 months or whatever. So that's kind of continuously evolving with Jenkins X. I just want to focus on the preview environment a bit, because I think it's a very important feature, like a killer feature of Jenkins X, with two different examples. So we can have preview environment per application. In that case, we are going to define the preview environment like just as a directory inside the application's Git repository. And we can say, we can include dependencies. For example, let's say we have a UI application which needs an API. So in our preview environment, we can define in Git that we want a specific version of the API. And once it will be deployed, we can run our integration test on the UI, targeting also the API. So that's great, because if there is a new version of the API, you can just update the file, switch a version, and it will use that new version. And it can have transitive dependencies because it's using Elm. So if the API comes with a database, it will get it to and so on. That's a simple use case, but you can have more complex use case too. You can, for example, have a preview environment across multiple applications. The use case for that is when you have one feature that is developed across multiple applications, like multiple components. And how do you ensure that it's been tested before releasing? So what we used to do before is to release everything, put it behind feature flags, and test, and if there is a bug somewhere, go back to development, and make a new release, and so on. But what we really want to do is to ensure that everything is good and validated before the release. So what we are doing is we are creating a new Git repository with a definition of a preview environment with a which version of each component we want to use. And instead of using release version, we can use just draft version, snapshot version. For example, the number of a specific pull request for each component, or for one, the latest one, or whatever. And that way, we can test, we can create a temporary preview environment with non-released code, and we can test it, and we can validate it. And once we are sure it's okay, we can release the application, all of them. And that's a very good use case of preview environment because you are releasing a tested feature. So what are the results? More testing, as we said, at the pull request level. So that's good because we are releasing a more stable release of our application. More release too, because each pull request merge is going to create a new release. So we used to release every 2 weeks. Now we are doing between 10 and 15 releases per day. More deployments too. So in production, we are not so we used to deploy in production every 2 weeks. Now we are doing like between 5 and 10 deployments per day in production. So we are not deploying all our release in production because sometimes a release will be so it's a pull request merge. So sometimes it will be more unit test. It will be documentation or something like that. So we don't really care. And from the state of DevOps report last year, we went from being a medium performing team because we used to deploy like 2 weeks, every 2 weeks, to somewhere between high and elite performing team because we are releasing more often, we are testing more, and so on. So that's very good. That's what we wanted to achieve, and we are really proud of it. But with a new feature, we have also a new challenge in what we are doing. So before we didn't care, for example, about backward compatibility because we used to release every component at once. So now we need to care about backward compatibility, but that's a very good thing. About feature flags too, we are using feature flags more and more to decouple deployments and feature activation, so that we can deploy seamlessly to production and activate the feature later. And progressive delivery, as I said, it's a new feature that has been added to Jenkins X. So it's natively supported by Jenkins X. And it's helping us improving our confidence in deployment. So that's very good. In conclusion, if you want to improve your continuous delivery platform, really don't focus only on tooling. You should focus on practice first. Like question your existing practice. Is that good? Do you want to keep using them? What are the other practices existing out there? Have a look at some books or blog posts or whatever. And tools by themselves are not enough. It's better if you know which kind of practice you want to apply first. Then you have to ask the very good question of do you want an opinionated tool or not? For example, Jenkins X is an opinionated tool. Tecton, no. So you can do whatever you want with Tecton. It's generic pipeline. So there are pros and cons, of course. So you need to weigh that yourself. And continuous improvement. I believe continuous deployment is better implemented when it's continuously improving itself. So a very good example of it is Jenkins X because it's continuously improving. And you can follow that road along with it if you are willing to invest a bit of time regularly to continuously improve your platform. And that will benefit your business and your product and everything. That's it. So if you have questions, please feel free to ask. And thank you for your time.
So yeah, if you have more questions, feel free to ask on the channel. And I'll just answer here. So now the team of 40 was the whole team working on our product. So like people were doing mix of business work and implementing the new pipeline. So if you're curious about Jenkinsx, feel free to have a look at the new version, the new Jenkinsx version 3, which is in alpha right now, which is much simpler than the previous one. Very different, so have a look and feel free to play with it. You will see that it's interesting tool. If you are willing to, as I said, if you are willing to invest some time in your continuous delivery platform and how it works and like continuously improving it, Jenkinsx is a great tool because it is continuously evolving. So it's going to, it's not going to leave you at some point on the road and alone. So that's a very great tool. Yes, we are doing microservice architecture. That's one of the core concepts behind Jenkinsx. One of the practices it puts, it asks you to put in place. So basically, one repository is one application. So one container image, one Helm chart that is going to be deployed. So deployment or stateful set or whatever you want to deploy, so that it can be versioned. Like each pull request will create a new version of that application in that repository. You won't have to manage like multiple applications in the same repository, which is much more complex with Jenkinsx because of the choice it made. So yeah, microservice is much easier when you are using Jenkinsx. It's made for it. Otherwise, feel free to connect through Slack on the Kubernetes Slack channel, for example, or on the chat here on the conference website. Oh, another question. Yes, so how do we handle third-party integration dependencies in the preview environment? Very easy. Because we are using Helm file to express our dependency. Basically, whether it's a third-party dependency or one of our own application dependency, is going to be the same. So we can add multiple Helm repository. So we can add one for PostgreSQL, for example, the Bitnami one, and just install the PostgreSQL chart. So very easy, you can add as many dependencies, either internal or external. So yeah, that's very powerful. And I encourage you to have a look at Helm file. I'm going to put the link in the channel. Yeah. If you want to express your Helm dependencies in a GitOps way, that's very nice. So we still have time for questions if you want. Or I can once again tell you that you can have a look at Jenkinsx version 3. Okay, I think this is going to be the end. So thank you for your time. And yeah, if you have more questions, feel free to connect through the chat or messaging system or whatever of the conference website, or Slack, or Twitter, or whatever you prefer, or GitHub. Have a good day. Bye. Thanks.